sermon, so I won't say more than that about it. So we begin on page 185 of the Book of Alternative Services. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Almighty God,
to you all have spoken, all is thine is known, and you are in your secrets are hidden. Bless us also for ours, by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, that we may glorify the Lord with you, and we will live in the name of our Lord, we may be through Christ the Lord. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you have taught us through your Son that love fulfills the law. May we love you with all our heart, all our soul, all our mind, and all our strength. And may we love our neighbors as ourselves. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
So Abraham rose early in the morning, saddled his donkey, and took two of the young men with him and his son Isaac. He cut the wood from the burnt offering for the burnt offering and set out and went to a place in the distance that God had shown him. On the third day, Abraham looked up and saw the place far away. Then Abraham said to his young men, "Stay here with the donkey. The boy and I will go over there. And we will worship, and then we will come back to you." Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on his son Isaac, and he himself carried the fire and the knife. And so the two of them walked together. Isaac said to Abraham, "Father," and he said, "Here I am, my son." He said, "The fire and the wood are here, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering?" Abraham said, "God himself will provide the lamb for a burnt offering, my son." So the two of them walked on together, and when they came to the place that God had shown him, Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order. He bound his son Isaac and laid him on the altar on the top of the wood. And then Abraham reached out his hand and took the knife to kill his son. But the angel of the Lord called him from heaven and said, "Abraham, Abraham." And he said, "Here I am." He said, "Do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, since you have not beheld your son, your only son, from me." And Abraham looked up and saw a ram caught in the thicket by the horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called that place, "The Lord will provide." As is said to this day, on the mount of the Lord, it shall be provided. The word of the Lord.
Praise be to God.
The psalm appointed is Psalm 13. It is printed in your leaflet, and we will say it responsibly by verses. How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me?
How long shall I bless you in my mind, and you be in my heart, day after day? How long shall I endure my life?
Look upon me and answer me, O Lord my God. Give light to my eyes, lest I sleep in death.
Lest my enemies say, "I have prevailed over him."
So sin must no longer reign in your mortal body, exacting obedience to the body's desires. You must no longer put any part of it at sin's disposal as an implement for doing wrong. Put yourselves instead at the disposal of God. Think of yourselves as raised from death to life, and yield your bodies to God as implements for doing right. Sin shall no longer be your master, for you are no longer under law, but under grace. What then? Are we to sin because we are not under law, but under grace? Of course not. You know well enough that if you bind yourselves to obey a master, you are slaves of the master you obey. And this is true whether the master is sin and the outcome death, or obedience and the outcome righteousness. Once you were slaves of sin, but now, thank God, you have yielded wholehearted obedience to that pattern of teaching to which you were made subject. Emancipated from sin, you have become slaves of righteousness, to use language that suits your human weakness. As you once yielded your bodies to the service of impurity and lawlessness, making for moral anarchy, so now you must yield them to the service of righteousness, making for a holy life. When you were slaves of sin, you were free from the control of righteousness. And what gain did that bring you? Things that now make you ashamed, for their end is death. But now freed from the commands of sin and bound to the service of God, you have gains that lead to holiness, and the end is eternal life. For sin pays a wage, and the wage is death. But God gives freely, and his gift is eternal life in union with Christ Jesus, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Welcomes the one who sent me. Whoever welcomes a prophet in the name of a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever welcomes a righteous person in the name of a righteous person will receive the reward of the righteous. And whoever gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones in the name of a disciple, truly I tell you, none of these will lose their reward. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Second invite. I hope everybody had a wonderful Lent and in Easter, and I'm back. Thank you. And I also feel it's time that I need to catch you up on some recent events. In 2004, I was ordained as a deacon in the Roman Church. In 2016, when I met my future husband, as an act of love, I requested to step down from my ordination responsibilities. I understand everyone has a story, and we don't know each other's story, except for Jesus. But I made a choice to lay down my gift. So not risking shaking someone's faith, or create a space for others to sin in word or deed. Because my story was not for everyone to understand. I knew the risks and the limits of my own heart had I continued in the role. It was our own Reverend Matthew who suggested I come and explore the Anglican Communion just before the pandemic shutdowns, allowed me the time to discern. And the more I learned, and the more I experienced, the more I started to feel a sense of place for me. There was a welcome I had never experienced before. It was safe, it was warm, and more importantly, it was widespread. So my conversations continued. I had a conversation with Bishop Todd, my priest of St. John, and other individuals, and with Matthew's patient prodding and encouragement, I made a decision to move forward. So my ordination would be upheld, and I will be adopted by the Anglican Church as I am. So if you're not doing anything on September 16th, apparently, I will be received into the church at the confirmation celebrations. This is God's victory and my reward, as promised in the gospel today. However, for me to rightly speak on how this journey of mine is testimony to today's gospel, I want to include the verse just before verse 40, which is, those who find their life will lose it, as I did. And those who lose their life for my sake will find it, which I have. And I've done it in you, my Anglican family. Let's start to unpack today's scripture. You ever try not to take something personally? It's very hard. There's something about getting ourselves to a place where neither praise nor criticism affect us with tremendous impact for long periods of time. It's a practice that can lend us a sense of freedom to outside influences. I'm not suggesting that we are not grateful for the praise, nor that we can learn from healthy feedback. It's about resting in the security with God. I recall the image of the beloved disciple who Jesus loved, who was reclining next to him, anchored in a sacred security. It's hard when we are insulted, but the truth is, that source of unwelcoming or insult may be dealing with their own burdens of emotions, belief systems, and opinions. They're not ours to own personally. But how can we defend ourselves? I think there's a pearl in today's gospel. Our reward for having faith in Christ. Jesus is encouraging his listeners, especially his apostles, that there exists a real intimate solidarity and identity between Jesus and us. God in Christ, Christ in the apostles. So would you agree that this is the very bridge that connects earth and heaven? Whoever welcomes you welcomes me. And whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me. Again then, when we are faced with insult, we are in Christ. And so he has bared the insult. And we know all insult was nailed to the cross. Could it be our reward then? The pearl for us is we are in his shadow of the cross as a defense to what could harm us. The gospel said there are different rewards for different callings. We don't have a choice then to take things personally, because they don't belong to us. They're the Lord's. Therefore, we are free. We are protected in security. We are rewarded. Just as we learn to receive our baptismal inheritance, we must learn to be hospitable in grand ways, not hanging on to tradition or old understandings that can shut doors, but welcome welcome others to come and see, so the doors are open wide. Welcoming all, for all are in Christ, and Christ in them. A bridge that spans over all trials, misunderstandings, and even our grief. Pointing from earth to heaven, where our eyes remain fixed. Toxic words or actions no longer have power to destroy us. It may sting, but it's the reward that we count on to heal and to live because of our faith. When we offer a cup of water, is it not the same as when we express our testimonial experience? The truth of redemption, instead of leaning on perfection, which always breaks our heart, leaning on Christ as the beloved disciple. Welcome others as I have been in my story. Count on the reward and be encouraged. Water is made up of two hydrogens and one oxygen. That bond together, if we think of that with ourselves and our life toward the Trinity, it has us as prophets whose mission is not to worry about predicting events of the future, but rather communicate the word of God working in our personal lives. Jesus tells us to be a humble listener, to generously to be there for God's children. We may not know the whole story, but we know we can separate the pain in whatever way is expressed toward us and direct it to the cross. So once removed, we then can see God in them. Courage to be that cup of water extended to refresh and cleanse, to participate in the redemption work Jesus shares with us. Let Jesus take the insult. Let him take the lack of clarity. Let him worry about the future. And we will, without those distractions, watch for God and others. For we have then shown them our generosity, in turn, welcoming him alone. The reward is ours, each in our own story. May we have the sight to recognize those rewards and tell others. Let us pray. Jesus, as we encounter you in communion today, do not let our weak attempts for perfection hinder the promise of redemption and resurrection in all things, that we may be that welcoming, refreshing water, learning to give and to receive in your holy name. We trust in you. Amen.
Turning to page 188 and standing as you are able, let us confess our faith as we say, we believe in one God, the Father of all, maker of heaven and earth, of all things seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, Lord of the Lord, through him all things were made, for us and for us.
the prayers of your people as we present ourselves as those who have been brought from death to life, saying, Faithful and generous God, hear our prayer. Faithful and generous God,
hear our prayer.
Holy One, you have liberated your church from sin and death, that we may be obedient slaves to righteousness and sanctification. In the worldwide Anglican cycle, we pray for the Anglican Episcopal Church of Brazil and for the Most Reverend Marianas Rosa dos Santos Passato, Primate of Brazil and Bishop of our Companion Diocese of Amazonia. In the Council of the North, we pray for the Diocese of Saskatchewan and for Bishop Michael Hawkins, Diocesan Indigenous Bishop Adam Pocket, for the Senate Executive Committee, Diocesan Indigenous Council and Council of Elders, for James Seddy College of Ministry, for Summer Vacation Bible School Programs, for Stewardship Education and Training, and for Renewed Lay Leadership. Happy are the people who know the festival shout and rejoice daily in your name. Faithful and generous God.
Amen.
In this week's Anglican Lutheran prayer cycle, we pray for the Right Reverend David Greenwood, Bishop, and the clergy and the people of the Diocese of Athabasca. Let there be greening, Assembly 2023, gathering of Anglicans and Lutherans, and celebrating the 20th anniversary of full communion. Faithful and generous God,
hear our prayer.
O most merciful God, Lord of heaven and earth, rule and govern your church as we pray for Bishop Todd and Archdeacon Maiden. And in the deanery of Lambton, we pray for St. John in the wilderness, Bright Grove, Christchurch Forest, St. Paul's Point Edward, and Christchurch Petroleum, that your church may be preserved in the pure doctrine of your saving word, defended against all adversity, and protected from all adversaries, that thereby faith may be strengthened and love increased in us. Faithful and generous God.
Hear.
Father, we thank you that you have released us from the law and that we now belong to Christ. Bless Reverend Matt, our pastor, Reverend Jerry and Canon Wendy, our honorary assistant, Reverend Kay, our deacon, Reverend Miles for bringing the word of God, those joining us online and for each of us gathered here. Help us always to serve you in the new life of the Spirit and bear fruit for you. Faithful and generous God.
Amen.
Receive the praise and thanksgiving of your children as we offer our gratitude to you, especially for Barb and Laurie on our parish cycle of prayer this week. May she walk in the light of your presence. Faithful and generous God.
Amen.
Almighty One, give the leaders of our nation and all in authority in the world ears to hear the warning of your true prophets, that they may obey your will and faithfully follow you, O God, as our ruler. Faithful and generous God. Compassionate One, look upon all who live at war, especially in Ukraine, famine and pestilence. Fulfill your word and bring them peace. Faithful and generous God. Gracious One, inspire this community with the generosity of Christ's Spirit, that we may welcome the righteous person and refresh those who are the little ones in our midst. Faithful and generous God. Your love is steadfast, established forever. Let your grace go forth to uphold all who are sick, anxious, or oppressed, remembering especially Yvonne and Joe, Sue and Peter, Marilyn, Iris, Nevin, Strengthen their faith so that they know that despite their suffering, they have not lost their reward. Faithful and generous God, embrace into your love those who have died, as we remember Frank Audi in our memorial prayer cycle today. May they receive the gift of God's eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Faithful and generous God. Lifting our voices with all creation, with St. Andrew, St. Peter, St. Paul, and all the saints, let us offer ourselves and one another to the living God through Christ. To you, God of mercy and justice, you have freed us from the dominion of sin and brought us into the life of grace. Let your love flow so freely through us that we may recognize your light throughout creation and welcome your presence in all people through Jesus Christ, our Savior, to whom with you, O Father, and the Holy Spirit, all glory belongs, now and forever.
Continuing on page 191. Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess
that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved you with our selves. We are truly sorry for you when we come to repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may be guided.
Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please rise. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you. gift of your Spirit, that we may follow the way of our Lord Jesus Christ and serve one another in freedom. We ask this in his name. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth. You are the source of life and life for all your creation. You made us in your own image and call us to new life in Jesus Christ, our Savior. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy.
As we forgive those who sin against us, save us from
Jesus Christ and fit us for his eternal kingdom, that all the world may call him Lord. We ask this in his name.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Whose power works in us,
finding a buddy to do it with, we would really appreciate it. Thank you.